a big score on that vault. Now here's Sean Townsend. His teammates call him Buddy Lee. They think he resembles the character in the commercial.
They also say nothing phases this guy. And that's a very good quality because he's got two major releases to get through on this routine. And more than just that, what makes it so critical in this exercise is he does both of them in combination, doesn't have time to set up for them. This one comes right here. Got that one. You do this from a skill before it, much more difficult. Not for Sean. Swung that dismount out there a little bit, but found the ground. He did a great job today. You know, he's been battling with some sickness, struggled through the Olympic trials. Not feeling well, got on the plane, long trip over to Australia. Had a little bit of a relapse.
Bondarenko, 9.75 on that vault. Big score as expected. And Townsend, 9.712. The U.S. really has gathered momentum, started slowly, and despite the fact that this man, Blaine Wilson, has had an inconsistent night, had the great vault, but not much else. And is he starting to press by now?
Well, I got to tell you, there would be a lot of people I would be very concerned about if they came out in the Olympic Games and struggled like Blaine has, but he's the kind of guy that just gets more and more mad. And that translates into a better performance typically for Blaine Wilson.
And Tim, Sean has really set him up beautifully. This score could be much bigger than Sean's 9.712.
A lot of intricate pirouetting elements. Just one arm coming up here in combination. More release right here, also in combination. Well, another hop for Blaine Wilson, and frankly, a disappointing day for him. On the individual side, I'm sure he thought he'd make a few different individual event finals. That's not going to happen. He will make vault. We'll also see him in the individual all-around competition and, of course, with the team, but really not what Blaine is capable of doing, no question. We saw flashes of brilliance on vaulting today from Blaine Wilson, but this has kind of been what the day has been all about, a dismount, and he can stick this one cold, but he lands a significant hop forward. You see the balance there. That can mean the whole ball game at the Olympic Games.
Blaine's sister Amy is agonized over every routine today and probably relieved that it's finally over and Blaine can look forward to a better day on Monday. His score on the high bar routine, 9.65. So the overall standings after session two, with a session yet to go, Russia, Ukraine, and United States. The U.S. looking good to make it to the final with one session to go.
Guys, come in here.
Guys, come on, man.
Come here. Hey, that was the best team effort that I've ever seen. From how you started, two words, team and test. That was no bigger test. He broke his finger. This guy had a rougher time than he's ever had, and he's been the backbone of everything we've ever done in the last 5 years. You guys all get tested in the last 2 weeks, but everybody got tested today. Nothing's going to happen to us in team finals that'll leave me close to it.
That was fun, guys.
Give me some love. We'll see one of the favorites, China, when we return to Sydney. A revolution.
In this country, there is a lot of pressure. Only the gold medal is recognized. We must carry this burden.
The head coach was fired, and assistant Wong Yubin took over, hardening an already intense program. Sydney would be his one chance, their one chance.
Foreigners don't understand our philosophy. They think we're too strict. But the way we see it, we're living and training as if we're in the army.
So tonight, China's teenage army marches onto the world stage with but one objective. It's the People's Republic of China. Memories of past failures must be erased, and their success to serve as inspiration for generations to come. This is the vow of the Chinese men.
Like newborn calves, we are not afraid of tigers. We won't hold back. We will not repeat their mistakes.
So here they are, finally at the Olympics, Li Xiaopeng and Xinghao Wei, at the very place the Chinese failed in Atlanta, the high bar.
And Tom, what the Chinese have done in their relentless pursuit of an Olympic team gold medal is pick their spots a little bit better. Don't take the big risk on high bar, on the major release skills. Do a Tkachev like that, a little easier to grab the bar. They're so dominant in so many other areas. Just get through this one. Focus on the things they have more control over. Don't always do the risky thing. Show off their bodies. The elegance, the artistry of the sport of gymnastics. And fix the sticking.
So a huge psychological barrier passed. The high bar went smoothly for China. After four rotations, China edges Russia out of the lead. China demonstrates how remarkable and fragile they can be. On vault, the teenage army looks like they cannot be great when it matters. Risky vaults and big mistakes. Their final rotation on the parallel bars, 19-year-old Li Xiaopeng has another chance to prove he deserved the spot on this Olympic team.
And don't ever forget one thing, that the Chinese are some of the greatest gymnasts that have ever lived in the history of the sport. Their physicalness, their ability to do incredibly difficult exercises. They have the goods to get it done. They just can't let their head get in the way.
And so the Chinese finish in second place in the qualifying round behind Russia.